Breaking: Trump just called U.S. generals into emergency war room meeting after what just discovered. No matter how deeply we bury our heads in the sand and no matter how much we don't want to hear it, deep down we know that this North Korea issue is bad. Our nation is already deeply embroiled in a war on terror, and it looks like we will also find ourselves, once again, locked in conflict with North Korea. The threat isn't a new one, but it's new that we have a leader willing to step up and do something about it. The left would like for you to believe that President Trump is making the problems with North Korean dictator Kim Jong-un worse because of his aggressive way of talking about the issue. And if his bark were bigger than his bite, and our president weren't willing to follow those words up with actions, they might be right. But if President Trump has proven one thing to us during his time in office, it's that he's not all talk, he follows through. In the case of Jong-un and his many threats and missile tests, the Daily Star reports that the president is gathering the resources that he needs to put his missiles where his mouth is, and do whatever it takes to keep America safe. Donald Trump has held a meeting on the North Korean nuclear crisis in the White House's famous Situation Room amid fears of war. Options for preventative military strikes were discussed in the meeting led by Pentagon Chief General James Mattis and the U.S. military's top officer General Joseph Dunford. Tensions between the U.S. and North Korea have been worsening as Kim Jong-un refuses to give up his quest for nuclear-capable ICBMs. The less-than-docile North Korean dictator has made multiple, pointed threats against the United States with little to no provocation. It's unclear what his beef with America is, other than just being the polar opposite to his own oppressed country. Or perhaps he considers us to be the thing that stands between him and world domination. Spokeswoman for the U.S. State Department Heather Nauert revealed the Situation Room meeting during a press briefing, which was then followed by a full statement from the White House. It said, "This morning President Trump met with members of his national security team to receive a briefing from General Mattis and General Dunford. The briefing and discussion focused on a range of options to respond to any form of North Korean aggression, or, if necessary, to prevent North Korea from threatening the U.S. and its allies with nuclear weapons." Experts speculated the meeting could have been to discuss responses to any looming North Korean missile tests, with fears of a launch on October 18. It's hard to say what goes on in the mind of someone who's holding 25 million citizens captive, allowing them to starve while he pours every available dollar into a nuclear program that is futile at best, and fatal at worst. It's not, however, hard to know what the United States will do about it. Yesterday, General James Mattis warned the U.S. Army to stand ready for war with North Korea. However, the U.S. has repeatedly said diplomacy and a peaceful solution is the leading option to end the confrontation with Kim. The meeting came after Trump warned the world is in the calm before the storm. Trump was briefed on the options along with his National Security Council and Secretary of State Rex Tillerson. The Situation Room often hosts war councils and emergency briefings SIC, during times of conflict or national crisis with the President and the National Security Council. It was famously pictured when President Barack Obama was monitoring the U.S. Navy SEAL Team 6 mission to kill Osama bin Laden. Many capable leaders have sat in that room and theorized as to the best way to keep America safe, but few that Americans have been as relieved to see take over as our current commander-in-chief. After 8 years of bowing and scraping to everyone who so much as breathed a threat in our direction, the United States is once again in the hands of someone who doesn't back down and can lead our military to victory. More from our source about President Trump's meeting with the military leaders. It came after the U.S. president cryptically said only one thing will work against North Korea. Trump has also openly criticized the past 25 years of U.S. policy on the Kims. The Situation Room, officially named the John F. Kennedy Conference Room, is used to deal with disasters and conflicts at home and abroad. It is equipped with secure communications equipment, and allows the U.S. president to command the nation's military across the globe. President John F. Kennedy commissioned the construction of the command center during the Cold War. Defense expert Harry Kazanese, director of defense studies at the Center for the National Interest, commented on the meeting on Twitter. He suggested it could have been for plotting out response to upcoming NK missile launch. It has been nearly a month since Kim last tested a weapon, last firing a missile over Japan on September 15. North Korea was thought to test a missile or nuclear bomb on October 10, but they failed to deliver on the fears raised by the CIA in Seoul. Escalating tensions, Pyongyang has threatened to detonate an NK bomb over the Pacific Ocean dubbed the Judge Bird. Trump called a meeting in the alternative situation room at his resort Mar-a-Lago as the U.S. launched a cruise missile strike on Syria back in April. The U.S. president also reportedly had a situation room meeting on September 3 after Kim's H-bomb test, and recent briefings on the disaster in Puerto Rico. Trump has squared up to Kim, warning he can totally destroy the rogue state unless they back down from threatening U.S. Tensions have reached new highs this as Kim Jong-un launched over a dozen missile tests and detonated his first ever H-bomb. The U.S. considers a nuclear-armed North Korea a threat to national and global security due to the state's unpredictable nature.